He stole $1 billion with a piece of paper. Bank robbery has evolved tremendously since the Wild West era. Perpetrators became more skillful with their devices and sophisticated by their targets, just like we're about to show you. Coming up is the top 10 most infamous bank heists. Better believers, you won't believe how the number one spot was pulled off. Forget about Jesse James' gang or Bonnie and Clyde. These old-school outlaws would be like petty thieves around the supreme Führer of stealing and robbery. So stay tuned till the end of the video to find out how he stole $1 billion just by lifting a pen. Let's check out number 10. On the 10th spot, a robber pulled off a heist on a supposedly impenetrable bank, then escaped through a window. This robbery came to be known as the Great Riviera Bank Robbery. In 1976, a group of 20 men led by Albert Spaggiari broke into Societe Generale Bank in Nice, France. At the inception of his idea, Spaggiari opened an account with the bank and planted an alarm clock in a deposit box. By setting the alarm to go off at midnight, he was able to determine if the bank had seismic or sonic alarms. Once he knew they wouldn't be detected by burrowing through the floor, the group secretly dug out a 25-foot tunnel from the sewer system into the bank. Yes, they waded through human fecal matter to execute this operation, but they weren't in deep shit. Once inside, they managed to take up to $10 million in gold, cash, jewelry, and gemstones from 371 deposit boxes. During their weekend in the vault, they drank wine, cooked meals, and used antique silver bowls as toilets. When the bank staff arrived, there was a message from the thieves on the wall. Without guns, without violence, without hate. Spaggiari was eventually arrested but managed to escape from a judge's office by jumping out of a window. He was whisked away by a friend waiting on a motorcycle and never recaptured, kind of like the charmer in our next spot. The Diamond Heist. A customer earned a bank's trust, then stole $28 million worth of diamonds for our ninth spot. Using the name Carlos Hector Flomenbaum, a thief spent a year gaining the trust of bank employees at ABN, Armo Bank in Belgium before robbing them. They trusted him enough to have a VIP pass that gave him access to the vault after hours so he could come and go as he pleased. Throughout the year of 2007, he posed as a diamond trader and was eventually given access to the vault. Flomenbaum stole $28 million worth of diamonds weighing 120,000 carats. Holy cow. Police believed he was using a stolen passport from Israel. He spoke English with an American accent and often wore a baseball cap. They were able to create a composite sketch of a gray-haired man, 6'3" and aged 55 to 60. But like Albert Spaggiari, he has never been caught, even after placing a bounty of $2 million on his head. Neither Flomenbaum nor the stones were ever seen again. Fortunately for this guy, he knew how to keep his mouth shut after the job. But our next heist participants weren't so tasteful. Up next is the Dunbar Armored Heist claims our 8th spot. On September 13, 1997, in Los Angeles, California, the largest robbery to have ever occurred in the US also happened to be an inside job. At 30 years old, Alan Pace was a regional safety inspector for Dunbar. As safety inspector, he was given access to the company's armored car depot, a prime opportunity for photographing the entire fleet. Pace recruited five of his childhood friends to ambush the guards at the stock vault one Friday night, a day after he was fired. Using the keys he hadn't turned in yet, Pace and his team were able to infiltrate the premises easily. Once inside, they timed the security cameras to avoid being spotted. And if that wasn't ninja enough, they then ambushed the guards as they took their lunches one by one. Hi-ya! Once they gained access to the loot, they loaded up an estimated $18.9 million into a U-Haul and escaped, nearly getting away with the whole thing by laundering the money into real estate and fake businesses. That is until one of the perpetrators, Eugene Lamar Hill, was arrested and confessed after handing a stack of cash to a friend for a real estate deal. Pace was arrested and sentenced to 24 years at the Federal Correctional Institution in Safford. He'll be 54 when he gets released, but could you imagine being 77 years old and pulling off a heist? Our next heist was headed by such a man. Let's check out this story. The United California Bank heist holds the 7th spot. In 1972, Emil Denzio, at 77 years old, masterminded a bank robbery including his brother James, his brother-in-law Charles Mulligan, and his nephews Harry Barber, Phil Christopher, and Charles Brokel. But first, why did these guys want to do this? Well, apparently, this goes all the way back to Hoffa's incarceration. In order to be pardoned, Nixon suggested that Hoffa donate $3 million to his campaign. Hoffa donated, but didn't like the contingency. So he found Denzio. a Youngstown, Ohio bank alarms and safe expert. Enticed by the prospect of $27 million in loot, Dinzio accepted. Plus, it helped that Hoffa was able to pass on exactly where Nixon's cash was stored. They rented a condo in Orange County and planned a heist on the bank. The crew dynamited their way into the vault and stole $30 million worth of cash and valuables and fled after scrubbing down the townhouse. The cops eventually identified the robbers through fingerprints found on dishes in the dishwasher in the townhome they rented. However, Harry Barber says otherwise. It wasn't the dishwasher, but there was a guy by the name of Dawson, and the car was parked in his garage. Now, I guess Mulligan told the man the whole story, and he told the story to the FBI. Then the FBI got a hold of Brogel or somebody and got them to go to court and testify against me. They didn't even know who I was. Speaking of remaining unknown, these guys are still a mystery. Let's move on to number 6. Belfast's Northern Bank Robbery. Posing as officers to gain entry, this gang of men held two families hostage in a separate location while they robbed a bank. On December 19, 2004, an armed gang arrived at the homes of two Northern Bank executives, Chris Ward and Kevin McMullen, in Pulglass and Laughlin Island. Ward and McMullen were told to go to work at Donegal Square West and pretend as if nothing was wrong, otherwise their families would be killed. After working hours, the two executives led the gang to the underground vault. The crooks made off with about 39 million pounds. Only about 2.6 million pounds were ever found, and the robbers are still unknown. It was one of the largest amounts of money ever taken in a bank robbery in the UK. All right, better believers, we're halfway through and moving on to our top 5. Snatching the 5th spot is one of the biggest bank heists in history, taking place in Beirut, Lebanon, known as the British Bank of the Middle East Heist. A group associated with Yasser Arafat's Palestine Liberation Organization exploited the chaos of the country's civil war and broke into the British Bank of the Middle East in Beirut. The bank, which was located in Bab Idris, shared a wall with the Catholic Church. The robbers took advantage of this weak point and breached a hole through that wall, gaining quick access into the bank. Forget about using crafty skills. The robbers simply used brute force, blasting through a wall in the bank shared with the Catholic Church using 60mm mortar shells. Reportedly, with the assistance of a bunch of Corsican locksmiths, the group then cracked the bank's vault and plundered its contents. Anywhere from 20 million to 50 million worth of pure 12.5 kilogram gold bars, Lebanese and foreign currencies, stocks, and jewels. Today, the loot is estimated to be worth over 3 times in value. If you thought you could get away with the heist, would you try and pull one off? Let us know in the comments section below. I know I'd be tempted, but killing people for money isn't my bag, so let's just learn about number 4. Recognized by Guinness Book of World Records as the greatest bank robbery in Brazil, the Banco Central of Brazil heist holds our 4th spot. Using a clever front as a landscaping company, a group of sly robbers managed to tunnel 250 feet right beneath Banco Central of Brazil. They rented a commercial property within the city and posed as landscapers. The gang behind this enormous heist spent 3 months digging a 256-foot tunnel to a position beneath the bank. Investigators noted the tunnel was well constructed, with air conditioning and lighting systems. Pish posh. Over several weeks, they tunneled up through reinforced concrete into the vault of the Banco Central branch. Then, on August 7, 2005, the thieves managed to remove 3.5 tons of Brazilian real notes. They also took a hefty amount of cash, luxury watches, gold bars, sapphires, emeralds, rubies, and diamonds. Oh my! Loads of diamonds! The total amount of valuables taken was about 100 million real notes, or 58.5 million American dollars. Many of the group's members are still at large, but this next guy didn't have such good fortune. The Knightsbridge vault robbery grabs the 3rd spot. Masterminded by an Italian playboy and criminal named Valerio Visei, Richardy! The Knightsbridge vault robbery resulted in a 62 million pound theft. Valerio Visei is a native of Italy, where he was wanted for 50 bank robberies. When he arrived in London, he quickly started his career in robbery to sustain his playboy lifestyle. On July 12, 1987, with the help of Parvez Latif, a cocaine user who was heavily in Visei's debt, they gained access to the Knightsbridge Safety Deposit Center vault in Westminster, London. The execution of this operation was surprisingly simple. After entering the bank during business hours under the guise of opening a safety deposit box, he and his armed accomplice subdued the manager and security guards. Then they hung a sign explaining that the center was closed and let in further accomplices. Eventually, they walked out with at least 62 million pounds in cash, jewelry, and other valuables, which is worth 125 million pounds at present. Vissery enjoyed a short period of freedom by fleeing to South America, only to be intercepted by British authorities and jailed when he came back to England to retrieve and ship his Ferrari Testarossa. Vissery was sentenced to 22 years in prison. This guy didn't leave anything up to guessing, but our next spot sure did, so let's move on. A theft that resulted in the heist of approximately $282 million. The Dar es Salaam bank robbery takes the second spot. The thieves used the prevailing chaos in the city to perpetuate the heist on July 11, 2007, receiving very little media coverage. To this day, few details are known about the robbery at Dar es Salaam Bank, a private financial institution in Baghdad, Iraq. It's unclear why the bank had such a lot of American cash available to steal. Allegedly, the theft was orchestrated by several bank guards. The government suspected the robbers also had contacts within local police and militias that allowed them to pass through various checkpoints across Baghdad undetected. No further information has been released about the whereabouts of the cash or those responsible. According to the police, bank workers showed up the next day only to realize the entrance door was open and the money was gone. It's believed to be the largest theft in Iraq since the 2003 battle to topple Hussein. Speaking of the devil, number 1. Another robbery in Baghdad became the largest bank heist in history. The mastermind was none other than Iraqi dictator Saddam Hussein, who gets to rob a bank only with a written note. What a privilege. Before the Iraq War began in 2003, he sent 3 large trucks to the central bank. He also sent his son Qusay with a handwritten note asking to withdraw nearly $1 billion to keep it from enemy hands. An unidentified Iraqi official with knowledge of the heist told the New York Times, "When you get an order from Saddam Hussein, you do not discuss it." The money was loaded into vans and drove away. U.S. troops later found approximately $650 million in Uday Hussein's opulent palace, and later recovered hundreds of aluminum boxes filled with $4 million in $100 bills. The craziest part about this? After U.S. troops recovered the money, 35 service members were convicted of theft between 2004 and 2008. Robbing the rich to feed the poor, and then have it taken away. So there you have it, better believers. Top 10 most infamous bank heists. Do you agree with our picks? Which one do you think deserves the number 1 spot? Let us know in the comments section below. Thanks so much for watching, and if you like this video, check out one of these.